We are now starting a series of shiurim on Etz Chaim. Baruch Hashem, we're Mesayim Otzrot Chaim. And we are now starting a series of shiurim on Etz Chaim. Now, the hakdama to this shiur really is a hakdama to the, it's very similar to the hakdama we gave on the first shiur on Otzrot Chaim. There, I would suggest to you strongly that before you starting these, this is, by the way, just a continuation of Otzrot Chaim, so I'm not going to be going through the basics at all here on these shiurim, but rather, anybody just starting off in this limud should rather refer themselves to the shiurim that we give on Otzrot Chaim. There, we give a hakdama on reading the a kitzu of the hakdama of the Rav Chaim Vital wrote in Shah Hakdamas, and plus answering up quite a few questions that people have about the hesitation of learning Bechlau, the inyan of Kabbalah, about koitzis netiyas and ad gil abayim and im hakodmin lo osku anachnu yasku. How can it be that our rebbein did not learn Kabbalah? How is it that we're coming on learning Kabbalah? Nasi meshuga. All these various tainas are dealt with over there, especially about the taina of Ein Adam Yochel L'Tayim B'Paldes Ela Acher Shemilik Cheso Im Bosav Yayim. The famous Rambam brought down in the Ramon Yodeh Sim Resh Men Vav Sif Dalet. So there we addressed all those points, so it's Kedai Me'od to see what we spoke about over there. Now, Rav Chaim Vital writes at the beginning of Etz Chaim two Chakiras, which we're going to try, and I stress the word try, to understand as best as we can. They're very deep chakiras, and the Mefarshim already point out there are various problems with them, and we're going to be yoytzi yedei chiyuv alimud hachakiras as far as magas yad. But before that, I'd like to bring my own chakira, a chakira which is yedu mefarshim as well. And this is the chakir, goes as follows. As we know, as we learned Otzrot Chaim, we saw that the Kadosh Baruch Hu is mishtalshel his all and sof into a mokum ponoi, as we've learned, and from this mokum ponoi, which he created out of the tzimtzum, he created the world of Adam Kadmon. From Adam Kadmon came out. Excuse me, from the Naim of Adam Kadmon came out the Esa Spheres, which created the world of Akudim, Nikudim, Brudim, and finally the world of Atzilus, and then finally from there is Mishtalshet to all the other Olamas of Bria, Yetzira, and Asir. So we find this world of this word of Mishtalshel, meaning coming from another process from a higher world, and following through from there. It's mashma from the Kitva Arizal that the entire Bria, the entire Metzias, whether it's Ruchnias, whether it's Gashmias, is begeder yesh meyesh. Right? We don't find that the Arizal writes that he created the world, but rather there was Ishtalshelus, and we see the way the Oilers come out from the Pedakudim, and how they create the Kalim, and how that creates this, and sort of the snowball effect getting bigger and bigger, being more and more Megashim, creating more of the worlds. The problem with that is that all the Rishonim are claw, and this is one of the Ikrei Munim that we have, is that we know that Kadosh Baruch creates things Yesh Me'ayim. Yesh Me'ayim, not Yesh Me'yesh. So that is a very sore point, and it's claw from the Rishonim, from the Ramban, others, that the Eibishter creates everything yesh me'ayin, creates something from nothing. That means we are a nothingness was created from a Kadosh Baruch Hu, not that there is an inyan of ishtalshelus. So how do we yashif this inyan? So first thing is that in Mevor Sha'orim, Mevor Sha'orim is, as we know, that the Basra de Basra, the Arizal taught Chaim Vital for 1 year and 10 months. After that, Rav Chaim Vital went back to Damascus, where he wasn't originally from Tzfas, and went back to Damascus and went over the learnings, the teachings of Arizal for the next 20 years after that. He wrote additions, which make up what we have in front of us, called the Etz Chaim. And the last final edition is called Mevor Sha'arim. And there he writes over there, I'll just quote you the last one over here. He writes Mevor Sha'arim, Sha'afilu Omnam, Kasher Olam Ritzon HaPoshut Lahatzil Olamas, Az Hutzruch Tchila HaKol Livroa HaMokam HaChalal HaPonoi. So first thing he wanted to do is to create the Mokam Ponoi. והנה אחר שאין סוף היה תחילה ממלא מוקום כל העולם שבורא אחר כך, ולא היה אז מוקום פנוי, הוא צורך אין סוף עצמו לצמצם מציוסו לאורו ואורו, ויניח מוקום פנוי להציל בתוכו עולמות עד כאן נשאר. So, we see clear from the Mevor Sha'arim this union of בתחילה בורא ועושה המוקום של כל העולמות כולם מראשית אק עד סוף עולם עשייה. Seems to be that there was an inyan of a bara, of a creation. It was created yesh ma'ayin. So that's clear. The chiddush even here is that even the mokum ponoi that we're going to speak about soon, the mokum where everything was created, is even a creation. That's a creation itself. Not like what people think, that it's a fact of lack of all, right? It's just not the ma'is tzimtzum itself creates the mokum, but rather, besides the mokum tzimtzum, there was an actual creation called mokum ponoi. Very, very strong mashma over here. that's the way it was. The Rav Meir Papirish was in Sadrim, one of the Sadrim of the Kitva Arizal, and he writes clearly over there, the Agor, he goes, Ma haya inan en sof terem atzilus? What was the role of the en sof before created? Tchila kol haya bora makom. First he created the makom, created from nothing. Va'achika hetzil es esfils betocho. So it's clear from the Raf, which is called, that was the situation that he created. Kadosh Baruch Hu created yesh ma'ayin. The Ramchal in Chokher Mekubal in Daf Beis in Reish Amud Beis, he writes the Mekubal. Hineni mode al kol ze va'adrava ze yesod binyone shamatzil ein bo mikra guf klal v'kol chaz v'shom. Yev shalom ar b'shum ofem sho'or yidbar yidpael v'yishtal shel ad yase miboro nivra. We can't say that there's this yishtal shlush from the Eibishter directly to us, and we're a chilek the Eibishter. There can't be. Hello, mi amai lo shamati yoser beinan abriya ki im hi yesh me'ayin velo yoser. All we've been hearing since we're children, we've always heard this inyan of yesh me'ayin. V'im kein ech ef shalom es ishtalshelus. How can we say this inyan ishtalshelus? So it's clear from the Ramchal that this ishtalshelus that the Riza speaks about is not the lok pshuto. It doesn't mean actually one thing coming from another, but rather there was a break. There was the Eibishter and the creation. It's einu doime zileze. The only shaila is why the Ariza say clear? You know, that's the problem. It seems to be mashma that it's one thing creating, not creating, but one thing just rolling off and becoming. And muting, becoming something else.
What's the question?
At
the beginning, everybody is saying Shmei, what's the first Nekudah? Then this Nekudah is Mishtachel from A to Z.
What do you mean from the beginning? Which part of the beginning?
Whatever. The first, at the beginning was nothing. From nothingness was Yesh Mei. Once you got the first yesh, like the Ayuli, the Ramban Ayuli Atura, once you got this first yesh within it as all the there. Ishtachlus from A to Z.
Yeah, but we don't see that in the Arizal.
Why?
We don't find this break. We don't find this.
He's never talking about from nothing to. It's
of course, he's talking from nothing.
No, he says, where is he starting from? He's starting from.
He starts off by saying there's the end sof. Okay, end sof is mishpashta.
But end sof is not a kadosh baruch. He's not.
He starts talking about the end sof.
End sof in itself is is a yesh me'ayin.
One second. That's not bechlal mekuvel lekula deis. Okay.
Rely on me.
So if you take on that the Ein Sof Baruch Hu is mispashet everywhere. That's how we start off the story.
Yeah.
And then he's mitzamtzem himself, makes a mokum ponoi, and creates a calf, yes. And around that creates the act, creates that, da 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 da. It seems to be shtalshus one thing to the other, mm-hmm. with no inyan of yesh ma'an
from the Ensof. From the Ensof.
Ensof is the Eibishter.
Chazir Shalom, if it's Bochu, you can't say the Eibishter. You can't say it on a good
way. Again, because he says Bochu.
Bochu isn't the Eibishter, Chazir Shalom.
Okay, one second. Okay.
I'm not sure if you're in the territory whether.
Yeah, I mean, so, we're taking on that the Ein Sof is a Kadosh Baruch Hu, okay?
Wow.
Yeah.
It's before you learn the lesson.
Yeah, that's right. The only the lesson says this, by the way, okay?
The what?
That the Ein Sof is a Nivra. That's it. There's nobody else that says this.
But if you say Ein Sof, it means that you know he has Ein Sof. He is Ein Sof. If you know he is Ein Sof, yeah? So you know something about him. So he can't be Kadosh Baruch Hu, because we know nothing about Kadosh Baruch Hu. Knowing that
there's nothing wrong with
no.
There's nothing wrong saying something's Ein Sof. There's nothing.
Ein Sof is
there's no secret about Ein Sof.
What do you mean?
Ein Sof just means infinity. There's no beginning. That's the biggest shvach that there is. We're not describing
the Eibishter. He knows all.
Let's put the lashon aside. According to all the mafarshim, that the Ein Sof is the Eibishter, that's the reference Eibishter, it means just a great thing, the Eibishter is no beginning, no end. Then we don't have Kodash. One second. So the Shomer Munim says something about it. He says, you know why the Arizal didn't spell it out? The Shomer Munim in Vikuach, I'll tell you exactly where it is, the Shomer Munim in Vikuach.
The Kabbalah.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. So he says beforeish that in his Hakdama that the Arizal did not have to write, didn't have to tell his Talmidim, which were Gedoyle Mukubolim Ador, right? Like the Al Sheikh Vakehena, he didn't have to explain to them these Poshi Yesoidas Ikrim that there is an Inyan of Yesh Ma'ayin. And therefore he starts off by being Mazmir Mikan Le'elech. Yeah? But Avada, the Eibishter was created everything that there is in this world, and it's not its Indian of Ishtadlus. We're just picking up the picture from the Ishtadlus onwards, but Avad the Kodesh Baruch Hu created everything. I will see exactly where that point was, okay? But I'm saying from the Poshut Pshat that we have over here, in the Arizal, we don't see any of this Indian of Yeshmaim. So that's important to understand that everything is a creation, and it's not like a lot of people think that. Take this, you know, I heard people saying that we're Elohims, you know, we have Ein Sof in front of us, inside of us, you know, because it's Shtatlus, it comes straight down.
That's true.
Well, I Elohim.
That's true. That's
so, Chalil v'chas, to say such a thing, because we have to understand that everything from the Arizal downwards is all Yesh Me'ayin, it's a creation.
But for Ein Sof, yes.
What?
We are Ein Sof.
No.
Yeah.
No, and I'll explain to you.
You just said it.
No, it's not.
What do you say?
It's not. It's not.
People say that they have Ein Sof inside.
Let's go slow. Let's build up the picture. Okay, so that's the Yesod. Yesod is Yesh Ma'ayin. Everything is Yesh Ma'ayin. Yesh Ma'ayin is that we have no keshut to the Eibishter. You understand? That's Yesh Ma'ayin?
Yes.
Okay, that's it. That's exactly the opposite of what you just said a minute ago.
No, not at all. Ein Sof is not Yesh Me'ayin. The Ein Sof is the Yesh.
Is the... No, I'm telling you, that's only the Leshem. Put the Leshem aside, please.
What did you say?
Okay, the Ein Sof...
Leshem is me? Leshem is that me?
No, yeah.
Leshem is that me? Okay.
Put the Leshem aside.
Okay, yes.
The Ein Sof Baruch Hu is the Eibishter.
You can't say that because the Ein Sof goes into the Chut. It's turned into a Chut.
Okay, I'm not gonna...
No, when you carry on...
Okay, so let's continue here. So... Now that we know the Ikriya Ikrim, that there is a Musag of Yesh Ma'ayin, as we all have known, and that's not a Stir B'chlal Ta'arizal, as we saw from the Shomei Munim. The question is, how do we understand the famous Zohar? The Zohar says, a Loshon of Ihu V'chiyuhi V'gurumi V'gurumayhu Chad Chad Bohon. That a Kadosh Baruch Hu and his creations are one. Right? Kul Shabiruchu, Oraita, Yisrael, Chatu, even though we don't find Mamash that lost in the Zohar, but as I'm in Pitkam, that it, everything is one. According to what we're saying, Yesh Ma'ayin, how can everything be one? This Bechalal, Eino Doime, what we find by the Eibushter and us, how do we stem these two things together? Okay? But that we have to understand a little bit of the Shtal Shlus of Dvarim. So, most of what I'm telling you right now is actually found in the at the back of the Shosh Hayam Chelik Aleph. He has a very, very beautiful mama, which he calls Bria, Bri, Yesh Ma'ayim, Esod Elkus. So there he speaks about the Esod of Elkus. We speak a lot about the Esod Elkus. What is this Esod Elkus all about? So I just want to quote you here. He says over here, on page Shin Lamed Dalet here, Be'ofin shiratzonil saneshoma yoitzin lepoel alidei guf. So here he's referring back to the world of Atzilus. Remember, we know there's a world of Atzilus. And then there's another three worlds, which is called Bri Yetziyasiya. The Zohar is clear to us that there's a huge chilik between the world of Atzilus and Bri. It's not like we always quote Abiyah, or we gather all these four into one, but rather there's a huge difference between the first and the last three. And he says, "Be'ofen she'aritzoynus haneshama yotzil mifor alidei haguf yachad ke'echad berega echad." Besod chibon nifle zehu nikra matzav shel elukus. Meaning that the Eibushter is mishtalshel his all and sof inside the mokom ponoi, and is mishtalshel it all the way down into Adam Kadmon, as we know, as we'll read more in details as we go through the Etz Chaim. We're just giving you sort of a shir klali here, and then it goes into this all and sof goes in from Adam Kadmon into the world of Atzilus. Okay, it goes into the world of Atzilus begeder neshama toch haguf. Neshama toch haguf. The Hainu, it's not one. It's not this O and Sof that we're talking about, but rather it's labshus of the O. It's labshus of the O. So therefore, the world is working in conjunction with this Elokus. That's what we talk about. That's when we use the word of Elokus. This is this relationship that comes out from the Ein Sof and the world of Atzilus together that makes it kechad. Kechad. I emphasize the chaf because it's not chad. It's two different things. You have the boire and you have the nivra. Remember, that's what's the problem? The problem is we have that we have the Lashonis of the Arizal, and the Lashonis of the Arizal talking about Ishtalshlus, where the Lashon of the Zohar talking about that it's called Kul Echad Hu, Kul Shabiruch Hu, Reis Echad Hu. How can it be one? How can it be the Boira becomes one with the Nivra? Doesn't make any sense. Teretz is, it's all together Nishama B'toch HaGuf. Nishama B'toch HaGuf. One has nothing to do with it Be'etzim, but once they come together, they work together Kichad. Masha Einken, when you come to the lower world of Bri, Yetziyasiya, the Moshele is more like a person talking to another person. You have one Bria talking to another Bria. That means that the Avada, the Ein Sof, also goes down into the lower worlds. But it doesn't have the same Kesher, Bechlal Bechlal, as does it have with the world of Atzilus. Atzilus Kechadu, Masha Einken over here is Keshnei Gufim Zilazim. So that's the Kesha, and that's how we miyashiv, that's in and of Yesh Ma'ayin. Is that clear?
Mm-hmm.
What's not clear?
How's it miyashiv?
You understand the Kesha, right?
In the Losh, the Zohar, how you have Kachad.
That's right. That's mashma, that it's all Yesh Miyesh, right? It's all one thing.
Why you say that? Why? Because the Keshbuchu and Oraisan.
It's all one. And when you say the voltage Shtashalus, it means the all, the same all and sof, just becomes more megash, but it's kul echad. The same musik. Right?
No, I don't know what's the Keshbuchu.
What? What do you don't understand the question?
The question is, what do you see from Kutcha Bechu Yisrael Vores Echad? You see what?
It's all one.
What is one?
The it's all the Nivra, yeah. Right, which is us and all the worlds,
yeah.
Is one with the Eivishter. There's no difference between them. It's more Megashim than the other, but it's all. It's all more Megushim. It's all one Ishtashlis. Okay? That doesn't stem with the Yesoidas of Yesh Me'ayin.
Yeah, but how do you answer that? The Maimah still says they're all one.
Excuse me?
Maimah still says they're all one.
The Maimah of the Zayah.
The Piskum.
Yeah. There's still one, right?
Yeah, but how do you answer that?
It's not one. It's Kechad.
But it doesn't say Kechad.
It does.
No, the Zohar does, but not the Piskum.
Chaduya.
The Piskum?
Piskum says Chaduya.
Yeah, Chadu. So it says Tom Kechad.
Yeah, it's not so clear in the Zohar that way. Doesn't say Mamshah's word.
What you mean is the pisk, it was your lashon pisk.
Yeah.
You're saying the pisk is incorrect.
Yeah, that's right. It doesn't mean mamish.
That's right.
It's not mamish one.
Yeah, it's not
mamish. It is like a neshama and a goof inside. That's how we understand. You understand? The neshama is the Eivishter, and he creates what's called the goof, and it's mislavish the goof.
Yeah.
Okay.
But why the face red should be even the green?
Because we have a more of a shachas, we're higher up. I don't want to discuss where they're going right now. Obviously, there's different.
It's going to be English tachelus.
Yeah.
So everything is kichad.
Yeah. But the tachlis of bris is it's hard.
No, I know that.
We don't have to speak about the goyim. They're not part of the cheshbon. Come on. Anyway, but the vault over here is another question that we have is that we for emphasis with this. Is that who are we davening to? Who are we davening to? As we know from Kabbalah, that we're davening to, and we're making all the tikkun and zun de atziras, as we know from the Shulchan on Otzrot Chaim. Zun de atziras is our kesher, and zun meaning the shchinta, sheshoe beinenu, in the olam as a tachtoinim. And all the tikkunim happen in those. That means that all the shemus that we find, the havayas and the ekes and the savokos and kel and all the havayas, only come about in the world of Atzilus. Before the world of Atzilus is only Ein Sof. There's no other name we find b'chlal mentioned above the world of Atzilus for any form of davar ruchni. It's only Ein Sof.
Where does Shechin fit in with the Atzilus?
Shechina is much lower down, so it's lowest possible. Racha Leah.
With Machus.
Racha. Yeah, it's Machus, yeah. So that's what we're davening to. So the Maisha is, are we davening, and this was one of the snagdus that the Oilam, means the even by the Rishonim, the Rashbo, tiny this to Rabu Bulafia, he tiny that we have one God and you have 10 gods. You're davening to 10 spheres. All you're preaching about is the 10 spheres and how they're all up there and you're making tikkun and you're davening to the 10 spheres. It's a kasha, if you don't understand the inyanim properly. Teretzes and a chanami. We're taka making tikkunim in the Esses spheres. But what's inside the Esses spheres? The Esses spheres inside of them is taka the all ends off. And that's where our kavanah is. Our kavanah zavada is we're only poil. Paul, these tikkunim via the gufim, but avada our kavanas are the ruchnes shabo. The ruchnes shabo is the Ein Sof shabo.
So you still split up the Ein Sof as a ten.
But say this, so what? So it's not the body. It's all one. It's kul achad.
Different madgushim.
It's all. It's part of the thing. Same. A tree has branches. You're not looking at the tree separately. That was the havamina. This is Keser, and this is Chochmah, these are completely separate spheres, right? Teretis are all linked up on one end self, which is following in them, and that's why we can do tikkunim, and we can mention that we're davening to Zun the Atzilus, and making tikkunim there, is because we have the all end self, and that's the English term. Okay? That's a very important amal ha-muska to understand this. And just to finish off, I want to quote to you a Leshem, where she brings down Leshem over here, Leshem Shabu Achlama B'Sefer Deah. And Taki says these words, Mufosh, and listen to these words. So a long piece, I'm just going to read a few lines here. Amatil Yisborach Shemo. שאין לו גילוי כלל ולא שם כלל, אלא רק אחרי התלבשות באצילס. The Eibushter himself, the Atzmius, is only mislabish, and there's no mention of him whatsoever, only when you get to the world of Atzilus. Then, in the world of Atzilus, you have a gilui of the Eibushter. V'kol mila v'shem elokus asher amarnu hu, shuhu rak be'atzilus. Elokus, when we talk about elokus, only in those words, only in Atzilus. Rak aleidei yichudu behem, Vihine, when he's misyachid with the oilam of Atzilus, then you call that relationship Atzilus, Elokus. Hine zulas Atzilus lo nikra amatzil b'shem Elokus v'lo b'shum shem klal. Without these lavishus of the Eibushter in the world of Atzilus, we can't call him zero. El rak b'shem ein sof. He can only be referred to as the ein sof. O b'shem amatzil, the creator. Asher b'kol elo eno be'emes shemoitz klal. These are not really names. Ein Sof is not really a name. Just saying it's everywhere, there's no end, no beginning. It's not really a name. There's no form there. V'ari lanu, akol ponim, shehem shem havaye bochul, the yud kei vavke that we mentioned in all our tefillahs. V'hem shem elokim, whether it's a shem elokim, which we refer to as well. Shu elokus amitis yitbarach, hu rak acher shenitlabish be'etzilus. When in the world of Etzilus, then these names come out. Ki az nitgale me'ois ha'meshemois, aval koidem Etzilus, v'chem lemal me'etzilus, ein sham, ein shem alav klal. Ki hu nelam betachlis ha'elem. And that's the vault. Okay? So, we spoke about the Ein Sof being the Eibushter coming into the world, and even though they're the Hishtalshlus of the world, but what's the Neshama Shabo? That's the Eibushter coming always. But not to make the toast that it's one and the same. That's what just the Nekuda that we're pointing out over here. There's an Inyan of Yeshem Ayin, and that's Yesoidus. That's the creation that we live. We're all Yeshem Ayin, we're all created ones. But the Neshama Shabetoch, all of this, that Nekuda, which makes everything live and continue to living, is the Eibushter with is Mushim Shtalshel all the way down to all the B'liya, except in different levels. Okay, as we said, in the world of Atzilus, it's going to be Kirchad. When you come down from the B'liya and you see Asiya, that's already a much further distancing, but Avada, the Ein Sof is there, B'tchila. Okay, any questions?
Yeah, you haven't answered this question.
Get to it. Now, let's start with the Chakiras. Now, we're going to start reading from the Chakiras. A few more minutes. of the Arizal. So here you go. Etz Chaim from the beginning. Be'ine tachlis ha'kavona shel ha'briya olomas ha'nivra ata shtei Chakiras nitz'asku b'hem ha'mukumal. So like we said, the Arizal is nitz'astik in two Chakiras. And as we said, there's going to be a lot of problems with this, but we're trying to understand them as much as possible. Chakira rishonu hu, ma shechoko chachamim rishonu v'achronim l'das l'sibas b'riyas ha'olam l'eze siba haita v'nimna v'gom v'gozu omek y'siba adama haya l'fi shehine hu yizbar muchach shiyesh sholem v'kol pu'ulosa v'kochosa v'kol shmotsa v'shel gedula v'amala v'kovod ואם לא היה מוציא פעולות וכוחות לידי פועל ומעשה, לא היה כביכול נקרא שלום לא בפעולות ולא בשמות וכינוי עליו. כי הנה השם הגדול הוא בן דלת אויסיוס, הווי נקרא כן על אורות הוויותו ונצחיס וקיומו לעד. היה הווה והוא יהיה. תרם הבריאה בזמן קיום הבריאה ואחרי התהפכו אל מה שהיה. ואם לא נברא העולם אז וכל אשר בהם לא יוכלו לראות אמיתס ההוראות להוויות יתברך הנצחית בעבר והווה ועתיד ולא יהיה נקרא בשם הווי. So he seems to be saying clearly that if it wasn't for the fact that the Eibushter was able to create a metzias, he wouldn't be able to mispashit himself and become sholem in all his midas. וכן באדנוס, וכן שם אדנוס, אני אקרא כן על הוראות אדנוס ליוס לו אבודים. ועודם עליהם, ואם לא היה נברא, הם לא יוכלו להיקרא לו בשם אדנון. ועדר זה בשעה שמו את כולם. So, if the Eibushter uncreated people, how can he be called Odom? So therefore, that's what is the reason why the Eibushter created the world, in order to be called an Odom. וכן בעניין הכינויים כגון רחום וחנון ערך הפיים לא יקורא על שמם זולס ביות נבראים בעולם שיקורא לו ערך הפיים וכיוצא בזה ושאר הכינויים כולם. How can Kadosh will call himself a rachum if there's nobody here that is merachem? So he needs to be merachem on somebody. So once it's the, therefore he has to create a people in order to have this title as merachem. Does that make sense?
No, you said Shmuel is forced to create the world.
That's what he's saying. Yeah.
Rabbeinu Tam says that as well.
I don't care what Rabbeinu Tam. Shmuel doesn't need nothing.
Okay, let's not get emotional here. Let's finish off. I will explain. Omna. Beyoisa lomas nivroim as yotsu poloso. Once the world is created, then only as yotsu poloso vekochosov yidbarach.
And now he's happy.
Lidei poel v'yinikra shalem.
Now he's happy.
Now he's called shalem.
Before he wasn't shalem, he was chaser.
Because he's a v'gam yesh shalem b'kol shemot. Now he can also be called shalem b'kol ha-shemois. V'kenuyim bilti shlu shum chisorim klal v'chaser. Now we can't say that he's chaser anything because now he created people and he's shalem. V'inyan atam. And he explains further. He's only called that al shem brim because of his creation. That he's going to future, he's going in the future create. Di lav havyem barim, because if he did not create that oil of alma, amaykri rachom v'dayim. It's mafush zohar that how can it be called a dayim, how can it be called a rachum if he doesn't create them? So therefore, he's kiviyochol forced to create them. Ela Hashem brim datidim kifi v'chole v'chole. V'parsh is bo. דף מבייס וזה לא שונה, אילו התפשת נורי על בורים, איך השתמדון לי ואיך התקיים מלא כל הארץ כבודו. So therefore, I get another Zohar to explain this story. So the first one to ask the obvious question is the Raf. Rav Meir Papirish, in his safe, a famous safe called Zohar, Zohar. In the Zohar, Zohar, again, it's not the Zohar that we know, it's the Zohar of Rav Meir Papirish. Rav Meir Papirish, one of the Mesadre of the not the Etz Chaim, but of the Kitva Arizal. The Ech Hakadosh Baruch Hu, how can it be that he needs the Nivra? Poshut Pshat, reading of the Arizal, how can he need the Nivra in order to become Shalom? Doesn't make sense. The Klal is Ein Hakadosh Baruch Hu Tzorech Lebriyah Me'uma. Right, that's what he's asking. How can the Kadosh Baruch Hu, we know Poshut doesn't need Me'uma, the Oz of all. The same question is asked by the Shomer Munim in the Kuach Sheni Ois Yud Gimel. Also in the Kiram Shlom in Shai Gulim Ois Chafav. The Leshem Shabach Loma Biurim in the beginning of Shai Gulim writes, Ein Abriyam Mosif Shum Shlema Klal Ume Uma LeHakadosh Baruch Hu. So how can it be that he's going about and the Zohar is going on about how it's the Brim, how the creation is mashlim his shleimus. Doesn't make any sense whatsoever. So the Leshem has a tremendous yesod, so it breaks down into three parts. And I want to tell you that this is miyuchat to the Leshem because the Mefashim don't go as far as the Leshem. And he's very, very mechudish in this gang, but we're going to be bringing a lot of Leshem, so we're going to be going in the Mahalach of the Leshem over here. So Leshem says in the beginning of Birum, there's three levels. The Atzmius of the Eibishter. And Ein Shum Rotzen O Sechel, Royen O Sechel Yichol Litfus Bo. You cannot bechlal be massing the Eibishter whatsoever. Ein Machshova Tfise Klal, says the Zohar. And the Gaon and Likutim says, Afilo Isur is here who, is there's an Isur to Mehaher Bo, Ad Kedikah. The Atzmius is left out of the picture. Then the next level is called the Rotzen. The Rotzen is what we call the Giloy. That's what we call the Ein Sof, Baruch Hu. And then the third level is the gilui of that rotzon. The Eibishter wanted a creation. We don't ask why he wanted the rotzon, but rather the story of what the Arizal is speaking about here is from the gilui onwards. The gilui is what we call the O Ensof. That's the gilui of the havayas and all the shemos and the kinuyim, rachum, medaya, mekehena, mekehena. That's where it came about. That's where the Arizal starts picking up the story over here of the shtashlus, and especially over here by the chakira. Meaning that the Eibishter had a rotzen. Now, we're not here to ask any questions on the Eibishter, but the rotzen had a tafkid, the gilui of that rotzen had a tafkid in order to be mashpia to Klal Yisrael on the world, hashpa. Now, I have to be makdim another kasher. There's a steel over here. Because in Shah Klali, he gives a different reason why the Eibishter wanted to create the world. Not because the Tachlis wasn't because in order for the Tachlis of being more Sholem, therefore Ein Melech Belo Am, that's not the reason. In Shah Klali, he says, Lehetiv Briyotzav, in order to be Metiv, his creation. So it seems to be too contradictory. Is it the tachlis of the nivra, or is it for the tachlis of the boira? Which one is it? So the answer is avada is the tachlis of the nivra, of us. Leheti boira, so that's the ikatam. But in order to mekayim leheti libruyoso, the Eibishter created a construct called the O Ensof, in order to follow through these instructions. In order to be mative, and obviously in order to be mative, and in order to mekaya the mama of the Eibishter, the gilo or itself has to create a mokum and a people where to be, where to have the hatova, in order to make that giloy sholem in his tachlis, and therefore, and what's his tachlis in order to be mative with the Eibishter. So that answers up, Baruch Hashem, according to the Leshem, and other mafashim in different ways. This question.
And how the other portion answer the question?
So they just don't go as far as saying that the creation is the O and so they call it something else.
I mean they're still masking that there's
that we're not talking the Asoy is that we're not talking about the Eibishter. That takes away all the caches. Problem was the Arizal says 10 times here that the Eibishter was chos and he had to create a people in order to become Ein Melech Belo Am.
In that case, you're now saying the same thing as he did.
I don't know what he's saying, but this is what the Leshem is saying.
I'm trying to understand what the Leshem seems so clear that I'm trying to work out what other people say.
The only difference between them, they don't say that the O and stuff. Just a lot. It's just a shayla in Loshem.
When
we say the O and stuff, is that a nivra? Or is it the Eibishter? Chelik, like the sun and the rays coming from the sun, right? The rays from the sun, you can tie it that's the chelik of the sun. Or Efshetak, it's not. It's a creation from the sun. It's a technical point. It's a technical point. But the Leshem saying clearly that it's a nivra. It's a nivra. Okay, but that's nothing to do with the chakira yet. For emphasis, the kasha of the Rav Meir Papirush, we're just saying that we're taking a step back. We're not talking about the Eibishter, and therefore we could talk about ishlemus in a bria. It was not shalom until the tachlis of it became shalom because it created a people. Okay, we're not going to have time to do the next chakir. Mr. Shem will finish up the chakir and continue on by tomorrow.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you guys have to agree with each other.